Catch a vibe with Big Hass only on Pulse. Pulse 95.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome to Catch a Vibe with me, Big Hass, right here, episode number 25. 25 episodes, you guys. And I said from the beginning that I want to make this a point to mention each and every episode, because inshallah we'll reach 100, 500, 1,000, inshallah. There's so much to discover. There's so much to highlight. There's so much to showcase. It's a huge honor doing this. Shout out to Pulse 95 Radio for giving me the platform and opportunity to do so. And of course, Sharjah Broadcast Authority. Catch a Vibe airs every Saturday and Sunday from 9 to 10 p.m. If you've missed any shows, please go to our YouTube. All the episodes are there on YouTube, on video, and also streaming services. You can listen to all our conversations with the amazing guests. Now, before I introduce our superstar for today, I gotta say that this show has rejuvenated me in great ways, because some days I'm feeling a bit low or down, and I come in here and I do these shows, and these artists inspire me with their passion, with their talent, and that automatically kind of really changes my mood in an amazing way. So most of the time they say thank you to me, but I want to say thank you to them. I just want to make this clear. Man, oh man, today's guest, I'm telling you, when you hear him sing, you're going to become a fan. That's it. This is a brother from Sudan. I've had the pleasure to see him, I think, for the past year and a half or so, like seeing him on social media here and there. The guy captivates, that's the word. Like, when he starts singing, it captivates you, it takes you to his world. And that's what's amazing about him. Like I say, he's from Sudan, singer-songwriter. Still discovering himself. He hasn't really released an original record yet, but he might be doing some original music for us tonight. But like I said, when I think about somebody that captivates, it's this brother right here. So let's get to know him. Myself and you guys, welcome the incredible Yousif Hassan. We're going to say salam alaikum.
Alaikum salam, Hassan. Thank you so much for the intro, man. Like, really means the world, man, hearing these things. This is the first time we meeting each other, and like you saying these things, like, I really appreciate it, and I'm honored to be here with you.
You know why, man? Because it's impact. And I'll start with that. And that insan alladhi la athara lahu la hayata lahu. A human being with no impact has no life. And you were able to at least impact me and impact so many people that, you know, listen to you. Yousif, we're going to hear you sing, for sure.
For sure.
But let's get to know you a little bit.
Yeah, let's go.
What was the spark? What was it about music that says, okay, you know what? Yousif, come here. Let's go. How did you get acquainted with music?
So I wasn't always singing.
Okay.
I was just a random guy.
Okay.
He was just doing whatever he want.
Okay.
In life, hanging with friends, watching football, play games. And
Aywa.
But I always had this thing with music. Like, it used to be like my relief place.
Who was an artist that you used to look up to? How did you get acquainted with it? You said that music was around you, but who was the artist that made you like music?
I cannot tell, like, a person or an artist.
Okay.
Because I didn't have that one. Like,
okay.
But since I was young, it was always like Space Tune songs.
Okay.
I used to jam on them. Like, but I didn't know that, like, oh, I have a voice. Or, yeah, like, oh, I want to sing.
Wait. Which cartoons? Like, which? Give me names.
Anything. Like, whatever Rasha Rizq sing.
Oh.
Which, like, she's my inspiration. If I have to pick one, it will be Rasha Rizq.
Rasha Rizq.
That's what it's like. Started there.
I've connected with her. I'll connect you guys, inshallah.
Like, man, khalas. If that happened, I will quit the next day. That's it.
Yeah.
So it just starts from there. Whenever I had a bad day, I used to like hum and like be like whatever it is. And I noticed somehow that this make me feel good whenever I'm having a bad day or whatever. Like, I started to feel when I started like growing up, then it's like, okay, like, this can make me feel better.
Yousif, when was this? Like, what year was this?
This, let's say 2011-ish.
Okay.
And then I was like in a place where I'm like changing my uni. I was going to new uni. So I was like, you know what? I want to be a new person. So I was like, let me do the things that make me happy. So I want to sing. Without knowing that I have a voice, like, God gave me anything. I didn't know that.
SubhanAllah.
Like, no one around me. In fact, when I started this, my friends used to laugh. And like, what are you doing and stuff.
Really?
Yeah, that's how I started.
I'm looking at the camera right now. Where are you right now? Look at this guy. He's on the radio.
So that's how it started. And then I was like, start pushing for it a bit. And it just happened. Like, then people start telling me, you have a good voice. Like, why don't you do this more? And then I started doing it not for anything other than to make me feel happy.
SubhanAllah.
I just felt like this is me.
I know I'm jumping again because I have a lot of questions, but sure. Are you still having a good time singing till now?
I can say yes. Like, one of my happiest moments, not when I'm singing, is when I'm on stage performing. And like, as you just said, I can see that I'm making people feel
big time
better, and like they are enjoying. I can just let them forget their worries and like whatever they've been through the day.
Yes,
they can just escape from that for a minute.
Three minutes, hour, whatever it is. Yeah. Oh my God. All right. So Yousif, you know, you figured out, you know, music because it makes you feel better. Space Tunes played a role. Cool. Now, two things right here. When did you decide, okay, you know what? I'm going to stop singing in the bedroom and like, you know, let's go. And I want to shout out right here, Blank Space. Shout out to Blank Space because they're the ones that actually I found out about you from Blank Space. Shout out to Hakam and the guys. They do an amazing job. Blank Space, go check them out. It's a community driven kind of a place and a platform that really. So I found out about you from there. I was like, bam, done. Do you remember the day? Do you remember the first time you ever performed on stage?
On stage
or like publicly?
It was in uni.
Okay.
It started in uni.
Okay.
But honestly, I don't remember anything about it because I'm sure it was so bad.
Why?
That's why, like, that day is gone from my memory. Like, khalas, like, wherever it goes.
But the question I want to ask you is, like, how nerve-wracking was it? Because for a lot of people, that first step, why did you decide to take that step?
Because, again, it just made me feel good. Okay. And I wanted to express that more. Like, I was like, I want to sing. But I can remember my first show.
Okay.
So I was performing with this, like, I don't know if you know them, but one of my close friends, his name is Hassan.
Hassan
Al-Jiri, he's a producer. He's
okay.
A member of Sound of Adiga.
Yeah, so, bro, wait. Sound of Adiga.
Yeah,
I love you guys. You're going to be in the studio real soon. I love Sound of Adiga.
They're my bros, like, I know them since forever.
Oh, wow.
And I started this thing with Hassan.
Okay.
So, he got me my first gig with other people.
Okay.
So, we were performing and, like, it was so bad. Like, the first one song, it was so bad. Like, I was so nervous. I was shaking.
But
so I went.
Okay.
You know these, like, movies
yeah.
where Hassan, like, when a person go talk to you and, like, then it changed?
Yeah.
The whole thing, like, changed?
Yeah.
So it was just like a movie. We went, like, somewhere. I was feeling terrible about the show.
Mm.
And Hassan came to me and was like, man, you know what? You have to enjoy it. Just remember, feel like you're singing in the... Because you always stay in college and sing in the stairs.
Yeah.
So you'd be like, just imagine it's like the stairs, like sing.
Hassan was with you in university as well?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's an incredible university. What university was that?
It's called Khartoum Al-Tatbiqiyya.
Khartoum.
Which really helped me to discover who I am, by the way.
Wow.
It's like one of these colleges in Sudan that you can just be you. Like you can find, if the moment you enter the uni, you can see people singing, people like playing, doing whatever.
Yeah, but this Sudan, yeah, wow. You said Khartoum Al-Tatbiqiyya?
الخرطوم التطبيقية.
التطبيقية.
Yes.
Okay. What did you study?
Interior design.
Interior design.
Yes, but I didn't finish it though.
Oh, interior design. That you, man. I mean, you're designing, you know, incredible things right here with your voice, man. Oh man. Okay. Okay.
So yeah. So then he was like talking to me like just do what you want, be free, like enjoy it, and then. The remaining of the show was like amazing. We killed it that day. It was like, And then from that day, we started like having gigs. We started, and then it started building up.
Wow. I love the story because it's different than, you know, some of the stories that we heard here. This is a guy who says, you know, obviously music made me feel better and I didn't know how my voice is and I just wanted to do it and, you know, bam, it just makes him feel better. I want to put you on the spot if you don't mind, Yousif. Oshay, God bless you, my brother.
Thank you.
I got a couple of records right here, and I want you to obviously the one I have right here in front of us is the Bruno Mars record when I was your man. Why is this song special to you, and why is Bruno special to you?
He was the reason that I decided to sing, because when I looked at him, and it's not only about his voice, it's more than that. Like the way I see him on stage, that's what really. Want me to go into music.
Mm.
And
He impacted
you. I can see
you.
Him like, yeah, exactly. I can see him there having fun, enjoying with his band that's been with him since forever. And they're like you can see it on them that they're having fun. They're enjoying their time. And I was like, I want that.
I want that.
Exactly.
Yeah. Man. All right. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, Yousif Hassan, I want you to get closer to the microphone or get the microphone closer to you.
Sure.
Where you're about, I just want to give you like a, what you call like a public service announcement, because you're about, okay, you heard us talk for 10 minutes right now, but you're about to really, really, I'm serious, go into another world, which I'm truly honored to have someone like Yousif on the show, because this is why this show was created. You ready, my brother? All right. Let's go. This is Yousif Hassan. Pulse 95 Radio. Catch up.
Same bed, but it feels just a little bit bigger now. Our song on the radio, but it don't sound the same. When our friend talk about you, all it does just tear me down. 'Cause my heart breaks a little when I hear your name. It all just sounds like ooh, ooh. Oh, too young, too dumb to realize that I should have bought you flowers and held your hand. Should have given you all my hours when I had the chance. Take it, everybody, 'cause all you wanted to do was dance. Now my baby's dancing, but she's dancing with another man.
Oh, man, oh, man. Man, oh, man. That big, big round of applause right there. No. Wait, I'm going to stand up in the studio right here. No, this is...
Oh, man.
No,
I'll stand as well.
We're both standing. La, man. Mashallah. Mashallah, my brother. Seriously, there is... Mashallah, like, we're going to take a show break because this is incredible, but I'm going to put you on the spot again.
For sure.
Now, you're the radio host, right? And you have to play a record for the people that are listening in the car. What record would it be? It could be anything. It could be a record for Bruno Mars. It could be any record that you want, as long as it's, of course, clean and good. So go ahead. You choose a record.
I would choose the record that I was just listening to. It's by Earth, Wind, and Fire.
Oh, my God.
Boogie Wonderland.
Bro, this guy is going to take our job. That's a great record. That is a great record. We're going to be right back. Catch a vibe. Keep it locked. I am here with Yousif Hassan, who's from Sudan, who has the best of hearts, who is somebody I can tell from now. Man, oh man, you're going to be a star. I'm telling you, you are already a star. Keep it locked. We'll be right back. Catch a vibe.
Catch a vibe with Big Hass. Only on Pulse. Pulse 95. Pulse.
We are back. Ladies and gentlemen, catch a vibe with me, Big Hass. Every Saturday and Sunday from 9 to 10 p.m. We are with an incredible guest, you guys. An amazing guest, Yousif Hassan. Shout out to him. Mad, mad respect. We just heard him sing. he took me to a world. So Yousif, I was talking to you about my wife, my one and only. And I was like, man, this guy is just... it's not a recent discussion. And when I first saw you a couple of years ago, or a year and a half ago, I was telling her... And I don't know if this, what I'm about to say, would make sense to you, but that's what exactly what I said to her. It's like, man, this guy just... It's like, it reminds me of Luther Vandross. Does that make... Like, do you like Luther Vandross?
Come on, man. One of my idols, yeah.
Wow.
Sure. Like Luther, Stevie Wonder, Bruno Mars, like these are the people that I feel that I'm connected to through their music, through their art. Like if like that's me, like I would be doing this music.
Mm. So we're gonna get a bit deep right now with the conversations. Like the kind of music that you like, right? Like what would you kind of box it in? Like what are we talking about? Are we talking about with Stevie and Luther? What's that? Is it like it's some sort of like the genre of music? Are we talking soul, R&B?
I don't know.
Okay.
I've never tried to think. Like people when listen to me like, oh, R&B.
Yeah.
Other people like, oh, pop. Some people say like soul. Like,
great. But you're not boxed in so far.
I don't like that.
Yeah. Perfect. Okay. And I love that. Now this is it. because of the style of music, obviously, that you do, it's not rap.
Yeah.
When I say rap, meaning a lot of people think that rap is associated with messages, and it's the only art form where people can give the messages in. Whereas other forms, it's more for entertaining and just a vibe.
True.
With you, at Yousif, what do you think about this specific point? Do you think you... Because I disagree with that. I think that you can have a message with an R&B record.
Exactly. Yeah. You can have a message with everything.
Yeah.
Like Bob Marley.
Yeah.
Have a message.
Yeah, that's my
Michael
point.
Jackson.
Yeah.
Have a message.
Pop.
These people like.
Yeah.
But I think it's like rap. Have that more.
Yeah.
Because now, especially with the world, it's like everything else is like dedicated to mainstream things.
Mm-mm.
Rap's still like there. Like there are people who are like
raw.
Having a message with rap.
Yeah.
But some artists have a message and they are doing that.
Yeah, agree. I think this is a question that you know it's coming, but obviously from Sudan.
Yeah.
Singing in English, has Arabic ever crossed your mind?
It has, but I'm not good at singing in Arabic, so like...
So wait, you tried Arabic before?
I tried.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
The first time I sang it was in Arabic, like in uni, it used to be in Arabic. But I didn't feel that I'm connected. And back then, what I really wanted, I felt like Arabic, like many of my jams in like Arabic music, Arabic songs.
Yeah.
But how I feel inside and what I want to achieve, it's like, I want to be in that level, like the level of Bob Marley, the level of Michael Jackson, the level of like, I'm everywhere. Like I sing everywhere, all over the world.
Mm.
And Arabic can get me there. I know that, but I don't feel connected.
You connected more with English, and that's okay. I mean, for me, as long as it's not forced, don't ever force it.
True.
That's my request.
True.
Don't ever force it. If it comes through, it comes through. If
exactly,
not, you know. Take me through, I don't know if that's, take me through the, obviously you're a singer-songwriter. You haven't really shared publicly, at least, like your songwriting, right?
True.
In terms of like official release out there.
Yeah.
Take me, what's the songwriting for Yousif Hassan? Like we heard you sing for Bruno Mars, we're going to hear you sing for the legendary Stevie Wonder. I can't wait for that. But yeah, what's the songwriting process, style for Yousif?
It just happened. Like, I don't have a process. Like, I know a lot of artists.
Like, what do you write about?
Everything.
Okay.
Like, it's not about something specific. Whatever start and happen, that's it. That's what the song will be about. I don't have that much yet.
Yeah.
But that's how I feel about, like, I don't want to label anything.
Yeah, so far, that's what I'm hearing. But later on, you have a record that at least you sent me. It's called Let You Go.
Sure.
And you're going to sing that. But, you know, obviously, maybe we'll talk, in the next segments about that. Okay, Stevie Wonder, I want you right now to tell me, because Stevie Wonder means a lot to me.
Oh.
And to all of us, of course, incredible legend.
True.
But let's say, by some miracle, Stevie Wonder sees this video right now. No, seriously, you never know how this universe works.
True.
What would you tell him, Yousif?
I love you and thank you for just like giving us all of these moments of pleasure and joy with your music.
What makes Stevie Wonder special in your opinion?
Everything. The package of Stevie Wonder, everything that he does. You cannot talk about music and not mention Stevie Wonder.
It's a fact.
Yeah, man. He's one of the greatest, like one of the legends of this industry.
A goat, like we say.
Exactly.
Like we say, it's a rap thing. Okay. Bro, first of all, the song that this guy sent is one of my favorite records. I know this record so hard, like so well. It's Lately. And I love this record. It gives me really emotional. So I just hope I don't cry right now because I'm Yousif. Man, oh man. You ready to sing for us?
Yeah, man. Let's do it.
He's ready to sing for us. This is Yousif Hassan. God bless him. From Sudan. Based right here in the UAE. Incredible guy, really. So much poise. Like, that's the word. So much poise and just, you know, humbleness. And you're about to hear him sing. You're about to hear him sing. Yousif, take it away.
Mm-hmm.
Lately I've had the strangest feeling. With no very reason here to find. Yeah, the thought of losing you been hanging round my mind. Far more frequently wearing perfume.
Okay.
Coming back soon, you don't know, never know. Well, I'm a man of many wishes. Hope my premonition misses. But what I really feel, my eyes won't let me hide. 'Cause they always start to cry. 'Cause this time could mean goodbye. Lately I've been staring in the mirror, very slowly picking me apart, and trying to tell myself I have no reason with your heart. Just the other night while you were sleeping, I vaguely heard you whisper someone's name.
Nice.
But when I ask you of the thoughts you keep in, you just say nothing. Nothing strange. Well, I'm a man of many wishes. Hope my premonition misses. But what I really feel, my eyes won't let me hide. 'Cause they always start to cry. Yeah. 'Cause this time could mean goodbye. Goodbye. Well, I'm a man of many wishes. I hope my premonition misses. But what I really feel, my eyes will let me hide. 'Cause they always start to cry. Yeah. 'Cause this time
ladies and gentlemen, I'm in the studio witnessing this. Allah yahmi. Yo, this is incredible. We're gonna take a short break. I'm actually gonna play Stevie Wonder's Lately. Just, you know, I wanna throw it out there. I hope Stevie Wonder sees this, and I hope somehow you meet Stevie Wonder, because I think this is incredible. Let's hear Stevie Wonder's Lately. You just heard Yousif's version. Incredible guy. Keep it locked. It's Pulse 95 Radio. Man, oh man, this is top 3 Catch a Vibe shows right now. Do not go anywhere. Keep it locked.
Catch a Vibe with Big Hass. Only on Pulse. Pulse 95. Pulse.
Ladies and gentlemen, Catch a Vibe, Pulse 95 Radio. And the music playing behind me is by the incredible group Adiga. Ya Allah, the groove, it's called. Love these guys. Yousif, you're close friends with them. What does Adiga mean to the music community in the world? specific in Sudan and in the UAE right now. They're based here, no?
Yeah. In Dubai.
Yeah. I mean, tell me a little bit about them, like, and why they're cool and important and just amazing.
I don't know. Like, to me,
yeah,
they're my friends.
Yeah.
But at the same time, they are, like, one of the most incredible, most talented
musicians
I've ever worked with.
Facts.
And if I'm good at what I'm doing, it's because I've been around them. And we've all been around each other since a long time. Like, I know Hassan.
Love that. Yeah.
I really learned a lot from being around these people.
Yeah, they're...
So I know Hassan since 2012.
Yeah.
I know Sid Ahmed from 2009.
Wow.
So I literally, like, if my music career started, like, I've been around these people.
Yeah.
And that's what really helped to shape me. Like,
You think it shaped you?
True.
Wow.
It did.
Mm. That's amazing. Do they ever, like, because they're really incredible musicians. Not critique you, but talk to you about, like, hey, you do this, do that, like, give you advice here and there.
Yeah, like, we're friends. Like, not friends, we're brothers, like, we're family.
Mm.
Like, now, even if I have anything, they are the musicians who play with me, and we've been playing together since forever.
Wait. Adiga plays with you?
Yeah, I'm honored to have them play with me.
Oh, my God. Yeah, because for me, they're really special.
They are.
Mm.
And not only special for me, they are special to
That's
all the community
saying.
Of
Facts.
Sudan and
Facts.
Everywhere.
Shout out to them. Okay, so in the next segment, we will obviously hear your original, but I want to talk more about what is it that you have in your notepad or iPhone or wherever you write. Do you have more than one record or song written?
Yeah, I do have, but not ready.
Define not ready. What does ready mean?
Ready is mean I'm not ready.
Wait. So you're not ready, or are they written?
Not all of them.
Okay.
I have like a couple of ideas, but still not finished.
Okay.
And when I'm saying not ready, honestly, like, when you talk to me, like, let's do this.
Yeah.
I was like, you know what? I want to come here and just leave something here.
Yes.
Which is this thing, which is not ready. And when I walk out of this door, I want to be like, okay. I said it out loud.
This is testing himself. Like, look at this guy.
Yeah.
Okay.
And by saying not ready, I've been like not ready for
a
long
while.
Time.
Mm.
Yeah. And
can you be ready, Yousif? I'm telling you. I'm going to tell you something that's going to shock you. Okay.
Let's do it.
You're never going to be ready.
I know.
Yeah.
But it's not about, like, for me, it's all about starting. And for some reason, I'm scared to start.
Why?
Does it make sense?
Like, I'm just the radio guy right now. So I'm gonna try to. What scares you in this?
To not be good enough.
Great. Okay. So let's talk about it.
Yeah.
You came in. You actually performed in uni publicly.
Yeah.
You perform around open mics right here.
True.
You overcame that fear of like public performance.
True.
You're on the radio right now. Chargers first and only English radio station, Pulse 95 Radio. People are listening to you on the FM, right? You had this to overcome as well. Right now with this, what's the worst thing that can happen? Just talk to me.
So the thing is, like, you heard me singing for Bruno Mars.
Correct.
Which is like a great record. You heard me singing for Stevie Wonder. When I sing, alhamdulillah, I know I'm good.
Okay.
And I know I have the talent, but that's not enough.
We need to hear Yousif Hassan.
Exactly. And Yousif Hassan, for some reason, scared from failing and scared of his things not to be good enough. And lately when I start thinking about it, it's happened for a reason. Like, I can know that that's what it started. Like, it all started there, 2017. Until now, I'm like, I'm at that place, which is like, am I good enough? Can I do something good?
I hear you. I respect it. But let me tell you, this is the first time we meet.
True.
And I'm 43 years old. Been doing this since 2007 in terms of, like, you know, highlighting and pushing. You're one of the best talents I've ever seen.
Thank you.
So if that means something, you know, like, for me, it's about the impact, like, you know. And I don't only say this. I've asked people about you and people, you know, because I haven't had the pleasure of watching you live. Yeah, but right now after this, it's going to be very hard for me not to miss anything that this guy is doing. So what I'm trying to say is that, first of all, there's not going to be one time that you're ready. Okay, so I respect what you're saying, but just drop. Like, just keep dropping. That's my opinion.
True.
And that's my advice.
True.
Because, yeah, that's how I see it. Because there's never going to be a one time where you're actually ready for this, because there's never going to be that.
True.
So if you have the records ready, cool. And by the way, I'm going to tell you something else, all right? This is the kicker. They're not going to be perfect. Because nothing's perfect. Only Allah's perfect.
It's not about that. Mm. So what happened, like, because I really want to drop it out so I can start from here. So in 2017, what it started is, I've been contacted by one of these Arabic shows.
Okay.
The big one. I came here to Dubai for an audition.
Okay.
It has to be a secret that you shouldn't tell anyone. And before it even happened, my friends, my neighbor, like the people in the neighborhood, like uni, everywhere, found out about it.
Oh.
And people went like, oh, when will you be on TV? Okay, is it happening? What's going on? And just, I went through the first audition, and from there, it's kept like on delaying, and keep getting delayed. And
it never really happened.
It didn't happen, but like, I was scared to go outside, because whenever I go anywhere, people start, hey, when is your show? When is your episode? And it just started happening to a point that I was like, so what happened was, I just found it on TV one day.
What?
Like, I reached a level that they contacted me, okay, prepare your passport.
Aywa.
Like, be ready. We will contact you for the visa and everything. And it didn't happen. And that was a process for a whole year, like from April 2017 till the end of the year.
Okay.
Without any notice, nothing. I just saw the show on TV.
Seriously?
Yeah. And when it started, like, they would start to air the show.
Yeah.
People kept asking me, like, hey, when is your episode? When are you going to be? And I couldn't answer anyone. And I started, like, being in this mood of, my bad. Like, what's wrong? What happened there? Because I can hear everyone saying, I know I'm good. Everyone saying I'm good.
Yeah.
Everyone
pushing me. But this one is not your fault.
I know.
Yeah.
But that's what happened, and people kept asking.
Like, I get it.
It just was from everywhere, and when it didn't happen, that's when I was like, okay.
Is this thing online right now? Like, is it online? The whole audition, you said the audition came on TV?
No. It was the first audition before
But it wasn't live. It never went live.
No,
it's not. And is there a reason for that?
I don't know.
Okay.
I've never heard back from them.
Wow.
And I was like, okay.
Well, it's their loss. I'm telling you right now.
I'm over the idea of the show, but I'm not over the idea of, am I good enough?
Okay. So listen, you guys, 4215, text us right now. And of course you're good enough. You're very humble. That's what I can tell you. You're very humble. You're somebody who, I think when you start releasing your original music, you're going to feel better. I liked your explanation about you're singing for Stevie, you're singing for Bruno. This is their records. We haven't heard, obviously, Yousif Hassan, what you think about, what you write about, what makes you angry, what makes you fall in love, all these things. So we're going to discover that. But it's a journey, man. We're going to take a short break. But Yousif, I'm going to put you on the spot again. What can we hear right now on the radio? Surprises.
Okay, since we talked about Sound of a Digger.
Yes.
So let's play Hanan.
Allah. Yeah. You know, it's my wife's name. It's called Hanan. So that's why I love this record. Sound of a Digger.
Let's actually
play it. So you're the radio guy. You present it. Yalla, how do you say it? Like, you know, this is Sound of a Digger on Pulse 95 Radio.
So, 3, 2, 1.
Go.
What I have to say?
I love that. Introduce it. Say, okay. You're now listening to Hanan by Sounds of a Digger on Pulse 95 Radio.
Okay. Yep. This is the camera.
Right? Yeah.
You're now listening to Hanan by Sounds of a Digger
on Pulse 95 Radio.
On Pulse 95 Radio.
Yeah, that's it. Keep it locked, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to be right back.
Catch a vibe with Big Hass only on Pulse. Pulse 95. Pulse.
We're back, ladies and gentlemen, with our last segment right here, Catch a Vibe, episode number 25. And man, oh man, it's been It's been so refreshing and rejuvenated on its own, this whole episode on its own. Mashallah, we are with Sudanese singer-songwriter Yousif Hassan, who is currently based in the UAE, trying to make a name for himself. And just, I want to say thank you so much, Hassan, for Yousif, for coming through and just being, you know, vulnerable, you know. Which brings me to my next question. We want to hear, obviously, the original. Okay. Tell me about Let You Go. This is the original track that is not released yet, but tell me about Let You Go, and it's not even finished yet.
True.
Okay, tell me about it.
So Let You Go is a track that I started many years ago.
Okay.
Like, nothing personal about it, but it's how I felt at that time. And what I felt at that time, it's like I was in a place where, like, it's always the women blaming men that, oh, you're doing this bad in the relationship. You're breaking our hearts. You're doing, you're cheating, whatever. Yeah. I was like, what? Like, we also, like, go through stuff.
Fact.
Like, you make us go through bad things. So I want to do something about that.
Oh, that's the record about?
that's what it is.
That's amazing. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
But then, like, that's how I started it. But after that, it wasn't about that at all. It was just about an experience. Nothing personal. So I didn't write the whole thing myself.
Okay.
I don't know if you know Ziad.
Ziad.
He's a writer. He's a producer.
Okay.
He's everything. He's
Wait,
one of
Ziad.
The most talented.
Yeah. Ziad, the poet.
He, exactly.
Of course, bro.
Exactly. Yeah,
of course.
He's
incredible guy.
Incredible.
Yes.
Guy. Yeah.
Yeah.
So he helped me write in the song.
No way.
And
shout out to you, Z.
Shout out to you, Ziad. And I also went to Ahmed Mekki. He's the producer of the song.
Yeah.
Amazing. Like, I went to him with like 3 chords and I was like, I want to do this. And he made like an amazing beats, which is still not finished as well.
Yeah.
Nothing finished about this song.
I know.
It's just like, okay, let me like tonight
try
do something. Yeah.
And it's bro, wow, this is incredible. Okay, before we hear it, I kind of want to put you on the spot, okay?
Okay.
I'm sure you know this record.
Oh, one of my favorites, man. One of my favorites.
Can you rock this? It's on the spot.
Yeah, let's try.
Alright. It's Yousif Hassan. It's Catch a Vibe. It's The Hunger, ladies and gentlemen. Alicia Keys. Take it away, man.
Some people live for the fortune.
What?
And some people live just for the fame. Some people live for the power, yeah. Some people live just to play the game.
Tell them.
And some people think that the physical things define what's within. And I've been there before. Now that's life so poor, so full of the superficial. And some people want it all. Woo! But that want nothing at all. If it ain't you, baby. If I ain't got you, baby. And some people want a diamond ring. And some just want everything. When everything means nothing. If I ain't got it, you.
Oh my God. No way. Mashallah
alaik.
I swear to God, this is incredible. I love it. Allah yahmi.
Thank you so much.
That was amazing. So 2 things I got to talk about here.
Yep.
Control. You can control that voice. You can go really up high and you can go. How did that come about?
I have no idea.
SubhanAllah, talent. Like talent.
I really don't know. It just happened. If you ask me what I think or do I plan to do this in that way, it's never happened like that. I just feel it and deliver
it. Comes up.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's what we call raw talent, ladies and gentlemen. This is raw talent. A couple more questions before we hear, obviously, Let You Go from you live. Live performance, and you performed, like, you know, you perform, like, in a lot of places in the UAE, mashallah. Take me through your set. Like, you know, I have a 30-minute set, let's say. You know, what can the audience expect? Because, you know, the crowd is always engaged with you, Yousif, which is beautiful, right? Like, Yeah.
That's his. Remember I told you at the beginning, it's always about making people have fun.
Yeah.
And enjoy. And I always like to make the audience interact, have fun, sing, dance. And I'm not trying, like, I don't try to force it. Like, I try first to read the room. If I can see the audience is, like, having fun, enjoying. And then, I would start asking them to do some stuff. What they expect? They expect to have fun. That's for sure.
Fun.
Like, to enjoy, dance, sing, do whatever.
And, yeah, no, I love that. But also, guys, you can expect to be blown away, like, with his voice. You'll be like... You know, just, you know, that double look, that's what will happen. They'll be like, what? This is exactly what will happen. You're like, how? Okay. Second thing is your thoughts about the UAE music community, Yousif. What do you think? What do you think about it?
Amazing, man.
Like,
and it have a lot of
diversity.
Diversity,
sure.
Exactly. And a lot of talented musicians. Like, in Sudan, what I do wasn't that much. Like, there was like, no much artists that sing in English.
Correct.
And play these kind of genres and music and these things. Now, there's a lot of Sudanese musicians that sing these type of music. But back then, it wasn't that much.
Yeah.
But here, like, you can see diversity, a lot of genres. I can feel that, okay, I fit more in this community. But also, I appreciate what I learned there.
Yeah.
And what got me here.
Yeah.
And also another thing, when you see all of these talent, that push you more. Like, okay, I want to be better.
Yeah.
Because also, I know that artists don't always talk about that, but we push each other.
Yeah, there's like a friendly competition as well.
Exactly.
It's cool.
So you can see that person, okay, doing that thing. You will learn from this and you will learn from that and take everything and just shape it to yourself.
Why are you performing, Yousif? Has there been a memorable performance for you that you could highlight for us right now? Like a performance that you can't forget?
I think 2 weeks ago or 3 weeks ago.
Okay, tell me about it.
Lock, Stock and Barrel.
Yes.
Yeah, we were performing there. It was amazing. It was amazing from all aspects. The audience.
The sound
people,
is great.
Yeah, the sound. Everything was great. The band. Like, I really love them. Shout out to Mujtaba.
Okay.
Shout out to Sid Ahmed from Sound of Adiga.
Yeah.
Shout out to Mu'min.
Mu'min.
Joshua.
Wow, Joshua.
Ahmed Abdullah. These, like, they're my family. Like, that's what I can say. And they've been amazing.
And in that performance, have you dropped anything original or was all covers?
Actually, it was a competition to sing original, but we didn't.
Because that's like, how you do it.
Exactly. So I was like, let me do something else. Everyone is singing original. Okay, I would not sing original. But it was...
Did you win?
It was fun. We didn't because the competition was about singing originals.
Yeah, yeah.
But it was good.
Yeah,
it was good that we started like doing and like started doing this as a band.
Yeah.
Which is like, we just started. That was our first debut, all of us together as a band.
So wait, you say a band right now. You have a band? Like, can we officially say you have a band? Or, like, you play with a lot of musicians?
This, like, we always been singing together.
Yeah.
With the same people, but we didn't have a name. So wherever we go play anywhere, they'd be like, what's your name? I'm like, we don't have a name. But we finally came up with a name, which is Back to Earth.
Back to Earth.
Yes, man.
Back to Earth.
Back to Earth. And we just started this, and we will... be doing it.
Is this official? Can we just خلاص back to earth موجودة? You guys are here.
Exactly. Yeah.
خلاص back to earth.
Back to earth. We're here.
Five people? What are you?
We are six.
Six.
Yeah.
Done. I'm booking you in the next show.
Exactly. Let's do it.
Back to earth. Done. In the UAE. All right, man. It's been a blessing, really. Let's put you on the spot. And this is something I'm really looking forward to it from the beginning.
Okay.
This is you. This is your own songwriting.
Yes,
with a couple of help, you know, from the legendary Ziad, and you know, production by Mekki.
Ahmed Mekki.
Yeah, shout out to him. Yeah. Let You Go. I guess for the first time being performed, and when it's done, you got to send it my way. We're gonna air
it.
Okay. I'm about to hear it as well with you guys. I haven't heard it. I told him not to sing it off air. Yousif Hassan. Oh, take it away, man. I'm telling you, incredible record. Wait, let me repeat that again. Because, you know, yeah. All right. His own original music, ladies and gentlemen. Catch a Vibe, Pulse 95 Radio. Yousif Hassan out of Sudan. Let's go.
came to tell me you're a carrot tonight.
Oh, okay.
Said I didn't love you, that I made you cry. That I'm the devil that broke your heart. And now it's time for us to say goodbye. Whoa. You said it's love that made you blind. Whoa. You blame me for your sleepless night. And I don't know what your friends been told.
Ooh, tell them.
I hear them whisper wherever I go. Wow, but it's okay cause they don't know. Whoa, they don't know what you wouldn't show. I didn't know I was coming over.
Wow.
And I didn't know about a man that you brought in my home. So I will just let you go. Cause you don't deserve the love. And I will let you go. Cause you don't deserve to be loved.
Wow.
Who holds you up when you're down?
Yeah.
Who cheers you up every time? It's you who ruined everything. It was always you, the one who didn't give a promise I won't say. But I'm losing my mind, it's killing me slowly. Would you set me free so I can be on my way? It must be what they call it, heartbreak. Whoa, you hurt cause I left first. Whoa, I bet that you've never cared. And no, I don't think that you've ever cared. You're just afraid, afraid of what people will say.
Wow.
So I will just let you go. Cause you don't deserve the love. And I will let you go. Cause you don't deserve to be. Cause you don't deserve to be loved. You don't deserve to be loved. You don't deserve to be. You don't deserve to be loved. Cause you don't deserve to be. You don't deserve to be.
You need to release this. Yeah, you,
inshallah,
Yousif, please. This is incredible. This is incredible. Man, oh man. Ladies and gentlemen, we've actually reached the end of the episode, but this is just mad. I could speak to you for another hour, but I got to ask you about this.
Yeah.
Thank you. That was incredible, bro.
Thank you so much.
The family. What's the sort of support you're getting from the family, or what do they think about the singing, Yousif Hassan?
At the beginning or now?
Both, actually. Yeah. That's
at the
interesting.
Beginning,
yeah.
At the beginning, I was hiding it. Like, whenever I had something coming up, I had to go to my friend's house, dress there, and go. But now, yeah, they are like very supportive. Like,
I can see what was the change? Why? They seen the impact?
Exactly. Yeah, and they start hearing from people.
Laugh
oh,
of
like,
them.
Yeah, and then it's like they start.
The parent, okay. When they get something, what's up? That's what it is. Like,
exactly,
yo, your
yeah.
son is amazing. Your daughter is amazing. Yeah. I know they're amazing. What are you talking about?
Exactly.
Allah Yahfadhum, man.
Inshallah.
Yeah. Oh, God bless. I don't want to end the show, but really, our time is up. Any last words you'd like to say? What would you like to say? Obviously, we need to release that original music.
Inshallah.
We need to, inshallah, hopefully one day meet Bruno Mars or Stevie Wonder.
Inshallah. Bruno Mars.
What else would you like to say to everyone listening right now and the people who are following you?
Yeah. So first, I want to say thank you for having me here. And the second thing, I want to say thank you to everyone who have ever believed in me. And I want to say sorry for not being at the level of your expectations. But inshallah, I will find a way to make you all proud. Other than that, I want to say God bless Sudan, especially with everything going on there.
Yeah.
And I hope everything worked for the good.
Yeah.
And we find a way to be better.
The Sudanese community and the people deserve the best.
True.
There is something about Sudan and me. We have a big connection. I love Sudanese people, the artists, the community over there is incredible, and definitely sending prayers and love. But ladies and gentlemen, if there's anything that you can take away from today's episode, is actually perseverance. He wouldn't maybe understand it right now, but I saw perseverance, I saw passion, I saw somebody that maybe, you know, is discovering himself and is actually vulnerable and letting us all get into it. He's actually somebody who's very strong. You are strong. Whether you see it or no, you are strong, because in order for you to give that power to people and that impact, you need to have that power yourself. So you are. You just have to find it within you. I cannot wait, Yousif. I cannot wait for the world to know more about you. I cannot wait to hear original music. I love the covers and I love how you do it. But still, Yousif Hassan, I want to know more about you, what you write, what you think. Can we do a promise on the air right now, okay? And say that Let You Go will be released this year. Just give me a yes. That's it.
Inshallah, man.
No. This year. Let's do it. We'll do it. Yes, this year. You got 3-4 months.
I can't promise that for one reason. I hope.
Okay.
But
what do you need?
It's not what I need, but it's more that I was about to, like, let me work on it and release it. But okay.
I
will give myself a bigger challenge.
Okay.
That I will work on an album.
Oh.
Release an album.
Well, he's a good salesman right now. Yeah. He bought me with the album. Okay.
That's the plan.
Okay.
Because I don't want to have, like, second thoughts about it. So,
Album or an EP. It. Okay, expect it. Yousif Hassan, where can people follow you real quick?
Instagram.
Instagram, Yousif.
Yeah, Yousif Al Hassan.
Yousif Al Hassan. Follow him. Probably, of course, he'll be tagged right here. Yousif, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
This is incredible. We're actually going to play another record by Sounds of Adiga, because they're incredible. I actually want to play. What do you think? Shall we play Salha Dance? Salha Dance or Salha?
Salha.
We're going to play that. Love you guys. Peace and love. Have a good evening. And we'll see you guys tomorrow in a new episode. Yousif, thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Salam.